Hey guys, and welcome to the first part of this Getting Started with Selenium WebDriver and JavaScript video series on the Lambdatest YouTube channel. My name is Ryan, and I'll be your host as we begin the journey into web automation with JavaScript. During this course, you will learn how to set up and write web automated tests in JavaScript using Selenium WebDriver. By the end, you will understand how you can utilize some of the awesome features of the Lambdatest platform to run your tests across multiple browsers and versions in the cloud. This first video will focus on getting everything set up so that in subsequent videos, we can focus on writing our first Selenium WebDriver tests. So now, let's start with some introductions. Throughout this course, we will be using JavaScript as our language of choice. JavaScript is one of the most popular programming languages, especially for web development. It has also become a very popular choice for test automation, and has seen the spawn of a number of testing frameworks, libraries, and tools, including Cypress, Puppeteer, Playwright, and of course, Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver is one of the most widely used tools for automating web-based applications. It provides us with a toolkit we can use to interact with a web application in much the same way a user would. For example, navigating to a page, entering text, clicking a button, and even selecting something from a menu. Selenium WebDriver can be used to build robust, reusable, automated tests, which can be run against multiple browsers. So now the introductions are out of the way, we can get things set up. Before we can set up our project, we first need to install Node.js. Node.js is a JavaScript runtime environment which allows us to execute JavaScript code outside of the browser. To download it, just navigate to the Node.js website and select the version relevant to the operating system you're using. I'm using macOS, so I would select the latest long-term support version here. Just click on it to begin the download. Once it's downloaded, you can follow the instructions to install. You may already have Node.js installed. To check, you can navigate to the terminal and enter node space hyphen v. This will work on both Windows and Mac. If the command returns a version, like here, then Node.js is installed. If you get an error, then you may need to complete the installation steps before trying again. Alongside Node.js, we also need to ensure npm is installed. npm, or Node Package Manager, is a mechanism for downloading and installing third-party packages into your project. Now, npm is usually downloaded with Node.js. To confirm it is installed, we can just navigate back to the terminal and type npm space hyphen v, and again, we should get a version returned. Now that we've completed our prerequisites, we can set up our project. To do that, I'm going to open up a terminal and navigate to my desktop. Here, I'm going to create a new directory called Selenium Demo. And I'm going to go straight into that. This will be the root folder of our project, and from here we can initiate a new npm project. To do that, we just enter npm space init. Now this is going to create a package.json file. But first, it needs some information to put in there. We can enter through each of these steps, which will just use the default value specified in the brackets. At the end, just click enter to confirm. Our package.json file has now been created, and it looks exactly like what you see on the screen now. Once we've installed Selenium WebDriver, we will return to this package.json file to see how it's changed. Now that we have our package.json set up, we can install packages into our project. As mentioned previously, npm is the mechanism for doing this. If I navigate to the npm website, I can search for node packages including Selenium WebDriver. Here you can see that each package has a description, along with instructions on how to use it, including code examples. It also provides us with the command that we need to run to install Selenium WebDriver into our project. So I can copy this now. This will automatically install the latest version of Selenium WebDriver. In this instance, it's version 4.0.0, which is currently in beta. If I navigate back to the terminal, we can paste our command in and hit enter to install Selenium WebDriver. This won't take very long. Now that Selenium WebDriver is installed, we can go back to our packages.json file. Here you can see that we now have a new dependency, Selenium WebDriver. This now shows that Selenium has been installed into our project. In the final section of this video, we will be setting up the browser drivers. Drivers are used to launch a browser instance in our test. To download a driver, we can navigate back to our npm page. On the Selenium WebDriver page, you will see a list of all the relevant drivers. For the purpose of this test, I'll be using the Gecko driver for Firefox, but you can use any of them. Be sure that you have the browser installed on your system as well. To download the driver, click on the link and locate the driver required for your operating system. I'm using Mac, so I will download this one here. Once downloaded, you can open up the driver and copy it to a location of your choice. I'm copying mine to a drivers directory on my desktop. Now that we've saved this file, we can update the system with the path. To do this on Windows, you can search for environment variables on the start menu. From there, you'll be able to find the path, which you can then update. On Mac, we can navigate to the terminal and enter sudo nano /etc/paths. You'll need to enter your system password, and this will show you the current paths file. To update it, we can just add a new line with the path to the driver. So in my instance, it's users. To exit, control X, Y to save, and enter to close. To confirm that that path has been added, we can open up a new shell and type echo $path. You can see that my new path has been added here. So that concludes the first video in this series. we now have everything set up that we need to write our first Selenium test, which we'll be doing in the next video. If you have any questions, you can find me on Twitter at RyanTestStuff, or you can contact Lambdatest directly at Lambdatest. You can also find more cool content from Lambdatest at the following addresses. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video.